Yo, CPA Strength here, back with another awesome video. Thanks for clicking on the video. If you could like the video, that would help get it out. If you can make a comment for the algo, or if you want to see something else, or what you think of the video. Anyways, this is Accounting for Beginners. I have a great playlist over here. Best playlist in the world. I've been running down accounts receivable and doing accounts payable videos for my last little couple videos. I've been posting weekly videos, holla! And I just wanted to go over the differences between accounts receivable and accounts payable, because they're basically opposite. I think they're basically opposites. And I just want to say how I learned the accounts receivable and accounts payable is, you know, if you know my story, I struggled with accounting. I was studying for my CPA exam and I really didn't know about accounts receivable, accounts payable. I had to break it down because I would always get very flustered, like, oh, well, this is a debit and then this went up over here and this was an asset. I formulated the DC Adler, so I had a roadmap. And I just remember, you know, going through questions and getting them wrong. And this is what I suggest for someone who's struggling, that you just, what works for me the best is get a scrap piece of paper. And on a scrap piece of paper, I would make something like this. And I would take half an hour. I know it sucks because you're like, oh, I'm spending all this time doing this. And I would take an hour, maybe something like this, an hour. And I would just really, really learn it. You know, I'd turn everything off, maybe some lofi girl music. I'd turn everything off and I'd just really, really, really learn this. And if you take an hour and learn it, you won't have to learn it anymore. You'll know it. And, you know, that'll save you. If you're doing this for a career or trying to pass a test or something, you're going to save so much time by just learning it. So let's go. Let's get into this. I hope we learned something here. So we got accounts receivable versus accounts payable. accounts receivable versus accounts payable. You know my DC Adler, if you don't, you've got to learn it. But debits on the left, credits on the right. DC, and then aid, asset, dividend, expense, asset for the debits. If an asset is going up in value or you're creating an account, it's gonna be a debit. So, an accounts receivable is an asset, and it's going to be debited, creating it or going up. So we're saying we're just starting our business and everything's going up. Conversely, so this is like a little mirror. Debits on the left, credits on the right. This is our little middle here. This is our middle. If you have an account payable is a credit. And it is a liability. Accounts payable is a liability. And if a liability is going up in value or being created, it's going to credit it. So on the DC Adler, you know, and an asset is generally good for your business. A liability is generally bad, you know, bad for your business. An account receivable, what would that be? Well, let's go with the good first here. So this is you. You're a business owner here. You are the business owner. What's going on with your business? Let's say you give a widget to somebody with no money, and now the account, what I say, now I want to look at the similarities and the small differences in here. They're both accounts. One's receivable, one's payable. Okay. One's an asset, one's a liability. One, you get, no money is exchange, no money is exchanged right now. So we don't have money exchanged right now. You're either giving something to somebody or you're getting something from somebody. You're doing either or. So look at the difference. Widget, no money. If you give a widget with no money, that's gonna create an account receivable. If you get a widget from somebody, that's gonna create an account payable. So just these small things. So now, watch this video, turn it off, get a little scratch sheet of paper, and take a half an hour and say, do I know what an account receivable is? Do I know what an account payable is? And boom, you've got a big chunk of the bookkeeping, accounting, you know, forever. It's not going to change. So this is you. This is your business. You're going to give a widget to somebody. You're going to, here you go. Here you go, buddy. Here you go. You don't have money for me now? The customer over here says they will pay. You're gonna pay me later. You're gonna pay me later, customer. Yes, I'm gonna pay you. I'm gonna pay you in a week. All right. Are you sure? Yeah. You don't have the money now? No. Okay. So what's that gonna do to my business if I've given a widget and they say they're gonna pay me later? That's an account receivable, because I'm this guy right here. I'm this little business right here. Look, boom. I got an account receivable. You owe me money. You're gonna pay me. I've given you the stuff and you're gonna pay me later. That's an account. Really, would you think it would be what would you think it would be? I mean, thinking someone owes me money. They owe me money. What kind of, you know, that's an asset, right? That's going to be an account receivable. I have a receivable. Conversely, let's go over here to the other side now. Let's go to accounts payable, which is a liability, credit going up. I get a widget. I'm getting a widget. Now, this is better for me right now. This is why you got to think, but I got to owe them later. But I'm like, yeah, just give me the widget, bro. Yeah, just give it to me. Oh, I got you next week for sure. Dude, no problem. You know I'm good for it, bro. You know I'm good for it. Come on, you got lots of widgets. Just give me the widget, bro. Throw me the widget, dog. Come on. You're the plug. Anyway, so I get a widget, no money. Thank you. I'm telling the big business, bro, you got lots of widgets, but you're telling big business you will pay them later. So, if I get something and don't pay them, if I'm getting something and don't pay them, I owe them later, right? I have an account. I promise to pay them later. I have an account payable. So you can see here, no money is exchanged. I know this is long and drawn out, but I just implore you to, you're like, oh, this is so simple. I know it. I mean, you're probably not here, but you're like, I know this is so simple. It's so simple. Then I implore you to watch the end of the video, please, for my watch time. And then take your own scratch sheet of paper, and I would say do something like this. This is how I learned. I always had trouble learning, although I was a little hustler. I always, this is the your custody over here. All right, this is how I really learned. If you're from, you know, if you're doing what you're doing out there, you know, hustling in them streets or whatever. You know, I started selling candy in the fifth grade. So, anyways, you're custy. You know what I'm saying? You got a widget, you got the stuff, you got the goods, you know. Here you go, bro. You're fronting somebody. That's an account receivable. You front somebody, that's an account receivable. Account payable. The plug over here. The plug, the big business, the big plug. You know what I'm saying? That happens all the time, right? You got stuff on consignment. How Biggie says, don't get on consignment unless you got the money. Don't, you know. But that's when the plug gives you. That's when the plug gives you some weight. A bunch of widgets, like 20 or 30 widgets, and you say I'll pay you back later because I don't have the money for it. I gotta sell the widgets to get the money to give them back to you. So you got stuff from the plug. That's an account payable. You got a custody over here. You got some of your custodies. You're serving some work too. And you got account receivable. So let's see the. So I want you to know the similarities and the differences. And after this, you're gonna know it. So similarities, both accounts. One's a receivable, one's a payable. Okay. The account receivable is an asset. The account payable is a liability. No money is exchanged now in either of these scenarios to create account receivable or account payable. No money is exchanged now. I think that's a big concept. Now you're either, you've got a widget. You're either giving it or you're getting it, right? You're either giving the widget, here you go, pay me later, or thank you, I pay you later. You're either doing, so it's either or. So we're trying to figure out if I give the widget to somebody and they're paying me later, that creates an account receivable. If I get the widget and I say, I will pay you later, that's going to create an account payable because that's a liability for my business. I am liable to you and I have to create that. So if there's no money exchange, you're like, dang, it's going to be an account receivable or account payable, but I don't really know which one. Well, one thing you can do is when you start your cheat sheet in the morning, you go DCA LUR next to the assets, you're going to put account receivable, AR. Next to the liabilities, you're going to put accounts payable. So when you're doing a test or when you're running through your day at work, you're going to say, oh man, I have an account receivable. That's an asset. That's going to be a debit. I have an account payable. That's a credit. An account payable is liability, so that's going to be a credit going up. So see how they're really opposites. There's some similarities, but small differences. What else do I want to say about this? What else do I want to say? I think I've pretty much exhausted what I want to say. I really hope this helps somebody out. I really hope this helps somebody out. What I think the beauty, I think, you know, the beauty of this is that you don't have to be ashamed that you don't know more than you do. Like, you know, I'd never be in my accounting class. I was too embarrassed because I was already older. I was in my 30s going to college with, you know, teenagers and 20-year-olds in my mid-30s. And I was embarrassed to say, like, I don't understand what an account receivable is. So you don't have to be embarrassed. You can watch this over and over as slow as you want. And I passed the CPA exam from watching YouTube, from watching different things, different YouTubers. And I'll even say, hey, watch a different YouTuber. So that's when I really, really learned to love the YouTubes, is when I was studying for my CPA exam. And so you can take it as fast or slow as you want. And the great thing about this is it's the double entry accounting system, and they made it 500 years ago. It's been the same for 500 years the world over. So think about it. If you take some time and learn about it, you won't have to learn it again. Dang. Anyways, I'm on day... day 63 of my burpees. I am feeling so good. One thing I want to say about is they say health is wealth. And I said, no, give me the money. But really, health is wealth. But I always thought it was just physical health. I know. I'm in my mid-40s and I'm just learning stuff. That's what happens when you do drugs for fucking 20 years heavily. Okay? You stop growing and you stop learning things. So, I just learned that health... is mental health is pretty much just as equal as physical health. So if you didn't know that, now you do. But anyways, I hope you learned something. Hope I can inspire. I came from nothing. People told me I was shit my whole life. I'm talking my whole life. No one ever said, hey, man, what do you want to be when you grow up? You know, you're good at this. Everyone just, I don't even know why I was around. Everyone just shitted on me. I got bullied in school. I was the fat kid. I was the smelly kid. I was the poor kid. I never had the good clothes. I never had the good anything. I was never good at anything. And, but I'm here now, and I'm here inspiring people and helping them learn and finding my purpose. So anyways, deuces.